science, technology, engineering, math, and art. Talk about filling an education vacuum. James Dyson is the founder and chief engineer of Dyson, the iconic vacuum cleaner company. He's hoping to spark a science renaissance in American schools. Welcome to the program. Tell me, what does a rich British inventor who went to art school, why are you so passionate about these innovation and science careers in the U.S.?
Well, the thing is that we're producing fewer engineers and scientists than we need in the future. I think that the jobs are being created in the scientific and engineering sector at a 70 times faster rate than any other sector. China and India producing hundreds of thousands more engineers than we are. And so I think our children are missing out on the fun and excitement of science, engineering, and design.
And, you know, it's that fun and excitement that will be the jobs of the future. The innovators will have the jobs of the future. Yet you're working with the Chicago Public Schools right now to promote STEM education and to raise science cores, which, according to the Institution of Education Science, future that 1% of Chicago's 8th grade students rated advanced on scientific proficiency, nearly 71% failed to meet basic standards. How are you going to try to raise those standards?
Well, we want to do after-school classes where children can learn to build things that they've designed themselves. The thing is that when you see something, and it's perhaps in everyday life, that you think doesn't work, you can actually set about and try and solve the problem. And in solving the problem, you're probably using maths and physics that you've learnt with other subjects. So the wonderful thing about doing an engineering and design class after school is that you can use what you're learning in school to make something that's relevant and exciting for you. And the most important thing is that in doing this, you'll be making mistakes. You're not allowed in any other lesson at school to make mistakes.
Huh.
But mistakes are really important because you learn from mistakes.
And I think a lot
when I made my vacuum cleaner,
the most famous inventors, really, you're right, you're talking about your vacuum cleaner, but a lot of the most famous inventions and inventors had many, many mistakes before they hit on the big thing. I think that's a really good point, that we should be celebrating mistakes and learning from them as well. But tell me what you're going to say about your vacuum cleaner.
Well, actually, I always used to think that children at school should be marked by how many mistakes they make, not how many correct ticks. Because if you make a mistake, you learn something. You learn something from it. You wonder why you made the mistake. And when I made my vacuum cleaner, I built 5,127 prototypes. So all of them were mistakes and failures, except the last one. But the only reason I could get there, the only reason I could make an invention and be able to file patents at the patent office, is that I'd done things that no one else had done, because I'd made all those mistakes and learnt from them. So it's in an autodidactic sense, if you teach yourself by learning from mistakes, rather than being taught by rote and just taking in facts that people tell you, if you can start to learn at school to be able to create things, learn from your mistakes, and do something that no one else has done before, that's the most wonderful and exciting thing.
And we have to make it fun, too. I mean, and that's a simple question of engineering for kids in particular. Design, engineering, science, to intrigue them, but also make it fun. How do we do that?
Well, you do that by making it more practical, by using your brains and your hands together. That's really my point. If you learn about physics, about structures, what makes a beam strong, for example, and then in your after new class, you go and you make, for example, a bridge spanning two tables out of cardboard that holds a very heavy book. You're applying the engineering you've learned about beam strength, and you can use your mathematics to design the bridge in a very economical way to support that book. And that's a fantastic achievement. Building bridges is incredibly important, and children can understand that a bridge doesn't just happen. Someone designs it, someone creates it, and someone makes it work so that lots of people can drive over that bridge every day. And that's the really exciting thing about engineering. You're creating things that make people's lives possible.
Fantastic. James Dyson, thank you so much for joining us. Best of luck in Chicago with your program. We'll talk to you again soon about innovation and the future and how to merge all of that with education. Thank you, sir.